Thank you. sure it's her carriage?
It's plainly and obviously a bridal carriage.
Merlin, here's a calamity. Guinevere's carriage is halted below the hill.
I know. I remember she would.
Sound the trumpet. We shall greet Lady Guinevere at the foot of the hill.
Come, Lionel.
Arthur, come down out of the tree. Your Majesty, come down at once. Walt, come down at once. You're perfectly safe. There's no one here.
Merlin, why are you so angry? I know you are because you called me Walt.
Yes, Walt, your schoolboy's nickname. That is what your behavior warrants. Perched in a tree, trying to steal a look at your bride. Will you never learn patience?
Well, I am king. Others must learn patience. Tell me, Merlin, is she beautiful?
I don't recall.
Rubbish! Do you mean to tell me you cannot see into the future?
When one lives backwards in time, as I do, and have the future to remember, as well as the past, occasionally you do forget the face.
Merlin, as your king, I command you to tell
me. She's beautiful! Quite?
Or very?
Very.
Merlin, why have you never taught me of love and marriage?
Don't scramble them together that way. They are two different things. Besides, I did give you a lesson once. But your mind was, as usual, elsewhere. You better heed me well. I shan't be here long.
Well, why not?
I've told you. I'm due to be bewitched by a nymph named Nimue, who'll steal my magic powers and lock me in a cave for several centuries.
Nimue?
Now, fiddlesticks.
Whenever you're displeased with me, you threaten me with this creature Nimue.
It's not a threat. It will happen.
Well then, when you know she is near, change yourself into a bat.
One cannot escape fate. She'll become a female bat.
Merlin, do you remember when I was a boy and you changed me into a hawk? Oh, what a feeling, soaring through the sky. For old time's sake, do it again. One last soar through the sky.
So you can soar through the sky, down to her carriage, and look through the window? No.
Merlin, as your king, I command you to change me to a hawk. Do as I say, or I'll have your head cut off.
It is you who keep on forgetting who you are. Think of the joy you brought to Camelot. A radiant young princess, never before out of the castle, brought by treaty to bring peace between peoples. A new queen, a royal marriage. And where is the king? Swinging in the trees. Thank heaven history never knew. Thank heaven Mallory and Tennyson never found out. Thank heaven your people are not aware of your behavior. Now go back to the castle, at once.
Oh, my people indeed. As if they give a thought to what their king is doing tonight. Oh, good and loyal subjects of the crown. Are you really peering at the castle with question marks in each eye? Or wondering about your king's humor on his prenuptial night? Why, yes, you are. Every last blessing, one of you. I know what my people are thinking tonight as home through the shadows they wander. Everyone smiling in secret delight as they stare at the castle and hum. Whenever the wind blows its way, you can almost hear everyone say, I wonder what the king is swear to you, by the sword Excalibur, I shall not touch you.
Why not?
It's true. The crown has made us clear. myself to trip and borrow a sword. So I went up and pulled at the sword, and pulled on it. But it didn't come out. I tried again, but failed. And then I closed my eyes, and with all my strength, I pulled at the sword. And look, it moved in my hand. Then it slowly slid from the stone. Then a great wall rose up around me, and when I opened my eyes and looked around, the square was filled with people, shouting, "Long live the king! Long live the king!" That's when I looked down and saw the letters of gold. Oh, I never knew I was going to be king. I never wanted to be king. And since I have been king, I have been at ill ease in my craft. Until I fell from the tree, and my eyes beheld you. Then, for the first time, I felt I was king, and I was glad to be king. And most astonishing of all, I wanted to be the wisest, most heroic, most splendid king who had ever sat on any throne. But if you come with me, then, I will arrange for your carriage to return you to your father. This way.
Oh,
Did I or did I not pledge to you 5 years ago that I would be the most splendid king to ever sit on any throne?
You did.
And have I, in 5 years, become the most splendid king to ever sit on any throne?
You have.
But I'm nothing of what I pledged to you I would be.
Of course you are, Arthur. You're the greatest warrior of England. Get up.
But for what end, Jenny? Might isn't always right.
Of course it is. Between right and lose, the couldn't possibly be right.
Oh, might and right. Babble and plunder. Those are the things that have been plaguing me all day. Merlin used to always frown at battles, and yet he always helped me win them. Oh, I'm sure it's a coup. If I could only follow it. Proposition. It is far better to be alive than to be dead.
Far better?
Then why do we have battles where people can be killed?
I don't know. Do you?
Yes, because somebody attacks.
Well, that's very clever of you, Arthur. Why do they attack?
Jenny, there's something I haven't told you, for fear that you would not believe.
Not believe you, Arthur? Hey, I would never not believe you.
Well, you know that Merlin brought me up, told me everything I know. But do you know how?
Well, how?
By changing me into animals.
I do not believe it.
There, you see? Well, it's true. I was a fish, a beaver, a bobolink, even an ant. And from each, Merlin wanted me to learn something. When I was a hawk, for instance, he said to me that if I was in the air, if I would look down, I would discover something.
What did you discover?
Nothing. Oh, Merlin was furious. And yet, on my way home this evening, while I was thinking, it came to me that when you're in the sky looking down, there are no borders, no boundaries. And yet, that's what somebody always attacks about. And they win by pushing them back across something that does not exist.
That's odd, isn't it?
Proposition. We have battled for no reason at all. Then why? Why?
Because knights love them. They love charging in and whacking away. It's plenty of fun. You said it yourself quite often.
It is splendid fun. But it doesn't seem reason enough.
Well, I think it is. And from a woman's point of view.
Well, it's wonderfully exciting to see your knight in shining armor heading bravely off to battle. Especially when you know we'll be home safe in 1 week for dinner.
Jenny, that's it. It's the armor. Oh, I missed that before. Only knights are rich enough to protect themselves in armor. They can declare war when it suits them, go clod-hopping about the countryside, walking away with peasants and foot soldiers, because they do not have armor. The worst that can happen to a knight is the occasional death. Proposition. Wrong or right, they have the might. So, wrong or right, they're always right. And that's wrong. Right?
Absolutely.
There, you see, Jenny, I'm not creating any civilization. I'm not even sure I'm civilized. Jenny, suppose we create a new order of chivalry.
I beg your pardon?
A new order where might is only used for right, to build instead of destroy. Yes, we'll ask all knights, good or bad, to lay down their arms and join us. We can take one of the large rooms in the castle and put a table in it, so that all knights can gather around it.
And do what?
Oh, talk, discuss, plan improvements.
Well, do you think knights would want to do such a peaceful thing?
We shall make it very honorable, the height of fashion, so that everyone will want to join. That's it, Jenny. Might for right, not might is right, might for right.
Sounds perfect.
And civilized. A page will build a whole new generation of chivalry. A page, tell the heralds to mount the towers and to assemble the courts in the yard. There's to be a proclamation.
of the table, to have created a new order of life. I worship you before knowing you. Beware, Mustafa, beware. From this moment on, you answer to me.
What a blood! What a blood! Magnificent! Simply magnificent!
Well, now that you have recovered, sire, I bid you good day. And remember, next time you raise the spear at me, you challenge the right arm of King Arthur.
But wait! I am King Arthur. Almost a late king.
Trust you? Your Majesty, I am not a self luck. I heard of your new order in France, and I came to join you. Well, Your Majesty, I beg you to forgive me. Not because I deserve it, but because by forgiving me, I will suffer more.
Really, dear fellow, I don't want you to suffer at all. Please rise. You too, Squire.
I cannot, Your Majesty. I'm too ashamed to lift my head.
Well, then I command you. I tell you, I've never felt a blow like it. Where did you learn to do it?
My skill comes from training, Your Majesty. My strength from purity.
Oh, a unique recipe, I must say.
He's a unique man, Your Majesty. At the age of 14, he could defeat any jouster in France. His father, King Ban, made me his wife.
King Ban of Benwick. What did you say your name was?
Lancelot du Lac, Your Majesty.
Lancelot.
My word, you're Lancelot. I was told you were coming.
You were told, Your Majesty?
Yes, by Merlin, our court magician. He said to me one day, Arthur, keep an eye out for Lancelot du Lac of the Castle of Joyous Skies. He will come to you and he will be... What was it?
Your ally, sir. If you'll take me. Your friend who asks not of friendship, your defender when you need one, whose heart is already filled with you, whose body is your sword and branch. Did he prophesy that, my lord? For all that, I am.
Really, dear fellow, it's almost more than one could hope for. More than one should ask.
Then you'll take me?
Oh, of course, without hesitation. We must arrange your knighthood immediately.
No, sir. Not immediately. Not till I have proven myself to you. All you know now of me is words, sir. Invest me because of deeds. Give me an order.
Now?
Yes, now. This moment. Let me perform for you. Is there some wrong I can right? Some enemy I can battle? Some peril I can undertake?
Well, actually, there's not much going on today. It's the 1st of May, and the Queen and some of her court have gone... May. I was on my way to surprise her when you surprised me.
Gone a May, Your Majesty?
Oh, yes. It's a sort of a picnic. You know, eat grapes, chase girls around trees, and...
A picnic, Your Majesty?
Yes, a custom we have here. England, you know. It's the time of flower gathering.
Nice. Gathering flowers, Your Majesty?
Well... Well, someone has to do it. Besides, it's civilized, and civilization could use a few gentle moments. And I want you to meet the Queen.
What is it, sire? Have I offended you? Did I say something that displeased you?
Oh, no, Lance, no. I suddenly remembered what Merlin said of you.
Strange.
How wondrous. He said that you will come to me, and you will be the greatest knight ever to sit at my table. But that was long before I had thought of a table. So he knew it would exist. Oh, I thought he meant my dining table. But he meant this, the round table. So I've stumbled upon my future. I have done the right thing.
Did you ever doubt it, Your Majesty?
Oh, of course, lads. Only fools never doubt. But welcome to the table. Bless you for coming.
dog that takes me everywhere. But I'm a paladin, aren't I? It's my fate. But sometimes I do wish I had a house of my own with real sheets and pillows and...
Come on, you man.
Life to the tortured quest for perfection and the body and spirit. Oh, no. I would not ask that of anyone.
Nor would I. Have you achieved perfection, my lord?
Physically, yes, Your Majesty. But the refining of the soul is an endless struggle.
I dare say. I do dare say. Do you mean you've never been defeated in battle or in tournaments?
Never.
Oh, and I suppose you find it highly unlikely to ever happen in the future.
Highly, Your Majesty.
Tell me,
licking nonsense. They're stepping on bugs, you know.
Penny, don't try to laugh at me with amusement. Get on with your move.
Bravo, Arthur. I agree completely. Let armor fight armor. Let knights fight fairly. It is not chivalry when only peasants get killed. Bravo.
Well, it's certainly more civilized. But read on. Come, Penny, either play or give up.
There.
The game is mine. Egypt is mine.
Oh, ball worship. How can a chap make the right move with Sir Perfect blasting away in his game?
I'm terribly sorry, Pelinor. I didn't mean to throw you off your game.
Apologies accepted. Really, chap, don't you have any hobbies? Don't you ever go fishing? Collect things? Catch butterflies? Aren't you interested in astronomy or making models out of clay?
No, pal, I'm not.
Have you ever tried to put a boat into a bottle?
Yes.
Well, Arthur, if this is the type of knight you intend to breed, you'll bore history to death. And furthermore, that idea of knights fighting knights is perfectly frightful. God's feet, what's the point of being a knight if you can get killed like everyone else? I tell you, the chap downstairs won't take to this at all.
Penny, all new ideas are resisted at first, but they'll get used to it in time.
I take a little ray of sunshine here. Never gets off it. Why can't he come home in the evening, hang up his sword and shield, and frolic on with it the way the other chaps do?
Don't worry, Penny. He will.
No, Arthur. I won't. Pelinor is quite right. I am irritating. I always will be. See, Pelinor, all fanatics are boys. And I'm a fanatic. Even when I was a child, I irritated the other children. All my life, Pelinor, I've laughed the whole world out. And you know, when you laugh the world out, you laugh yourself in.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Good day, my lord. Good day, my lady.
Good night, Lancelot. It doesn't take after his father. challenged him to a joust. Three damn strong men.
And he's agreed to fight them all on one and the same day.
Quite. I tell you, Arthur, in all my travels, I've never met anyone like him. He doesn't drink. He has no lady. And he talks only you and God. Crammed full of religion. An all-around unpleasant fellow.
Tell the chamberlain to order a joust tomorrow. You'll be Dinadin, Sagamore, and Lion.
Ah, very clever. Quit this chapel last day. Oh, what a day, what a day. Yours merrily can hardly wait. Quit this chapel last. I tell you, Miss Queen, you're a prince.
No thanks, Mr. Lionel. I'm allowing him to carry my crutches tomorrow.
Jenny, I ask you to withdraw your permission from Sir Lionel.
At this rate of gait, Arthur, that would be rather awkward.
Well then, I'll allow Lancelot to carry it against the Sagamore.
But I already promised it to Sagamore.
Well then, against Dimitri.
He asked so prettily, I could refuse.
Jenny, there are some issues here which you've obviously overlooked. It will appear to the court as if you're rooting for Lancelot's defeat, championing his downfall.
You don't know who he's defeated. Besides, he knocked you unconscious and you woke up his bosom friend. Perhaps he'll knock them unconscious too and they'll all take a house by the sea together.
Jenny, at the risk of disappointing all the knights, I ask you to withdraw your permission.
I believe you're jealous of the knights and their attentions to me. Are you, my love?
Jealous? Jealous of an absolute rubbish! You know that I'm perfectly glad that the court adores you. I would be astonished if they didn't. I trust you as I do God above. Why, they've carried your kerchief in tournaments 100 times before, And Jenny, you've drugged me off the point, and I want to get back on it. Will you withdraw your permission?
Only if you command me, as king.
And if I command you, will you forgive me?
Never.
If I ask as your husband, would you, as a favor?
No. The knights are against him, and I quite well agree with him. I find him just as overbearing and pretentious as they do.
Jenny, that is not the issue here. Can we not stay on the issue?
There is nothing more to be said about it. The king wishes for me to withdraw my permission, and let him command me. And yours humbly and graciously obey. What? What?
What? What? What? Oh, blast. Blast you, Merlin. This is all your fault. You swore that you would taught me everything from A to Z, with Navi and omission in between you. Well, I shall tell you what. You obviously forgot. That's how the rule of rules are, Queen. And what of teaching me by turning me to animal and bird, from beaver to the smallest bobo link? I should have
I have, Sir Dinadin. I prayed for all of us.
How benevolent. How benevolent. You know what I shall be thinking, Lancelot, when I see you upon your horse.
There he is, the Sermon on the Mount.
say, do you help think you could help with my rheumatism? Perhaps thinking out what is good. I have a pain. Stop.
I don't know, Penny. The boy is in the hall. Why don't you go down and ask him? The what? You. But quiet, I mean.
That's a bit snappy, Arthur. Very well. I shall.
Wait, Penny. I'm sorry. It was a bit snappy. But Penny, you've never been in love, have you?
No time, old chap. I've been too busy chasing after the bees. Now I'm not young enough.
Or old enough. And I am too young and too old. Too old not to notice fear that may be fun. And too young not to be affected by it.
I am talking about Arthur. Oh, good evening, ma'am. I say you were very generous with the boy. The way he looked at you and the way you looked at him, it was rather touching. Didn't you think so, Arthur?
Penny, summon the chamber. There are to be festivities this evening.
Festivities? Oh, well, I will have to go to the blacksmith and pick up my formal tongs.
Jenny Horton. I'm sorry, Dad. But they think we should invest that to me.
I quite agree. And don't worry, Jenny, I'll be all right.
And Jenny, you seem tired.
I am rather.
Why don't you take Lady Anne down to the loft? She always amuses you with her gossip about the court. And, well, I could join you for the weekend. And it might do you some good to get away from chivalry and around here. Don't you think? Don't you think?
Jenny, I love you. God forgive me, but I do.
God forgive me.
Notice it's the first day. Not when we met, but when I walked away.
Lad! Oh, lad, stunning achievement, my boy! Why, you could almost hear every heart in the court break open. Oh, it was magnificent. Surely I may arrange your knighthood now. Unfortunately, sainthood is not in my power.
I would be honored, Your Majesty.
Before we throw ourselves into pomp and ritual, I think the three of us should have a nice, quiet drink together. If you make an exception. Why, when people hear what's happened here in Camelot, why, they may come of their own free will. They may lay down their arms and join us. Why, no one could bear arms at all anymore. And all the borders may disappear. Why, their men may really be peaceful. And all the things I've dreamed, I have dreamed. Proposition. If I could
name change, we must surely do. Ruff, ruff.
Thank you. He just left, Your Majesty. He was here with the Queen.
You're not a member of this court. How dare you enter these grounds unannounced?
Well, I was announced, my lord. Did the Chamberlain not say it was a young man from Scotland who wished to bring you greeting?
And did the Chamberlain not tell you that all visitors were to return tomorrow afternoon?
I shall be busy tomorrow afternoon.
Oh, by Jove, what impertinence! He shall be taught a lesson.
Keep away! Don't touch me! I am unarmed!
Oh, Pelly, Pelly, call the guard. Have this young ass thrown out.
That's not a very kind way to treat the son of Queen Morgasse. Yes, Your Majesty, I am Mordred.
Wait, Pelly. Mordred.
Your Majesty.
Leave us, Eleanor.
I will be waiting outside. If you need me, Arthur.
I bring you greetings, Your Majesty, from Queen Morgasse in England.
I trust your mother as well, Morgan.
Mother is splendid, thank you. As witchy as ever, still beautiful. Which, of course, she would be with all her magic and sorcery. I've been wondering about the castle. I hope you don't mind.
And King Lot?
The king? Never happier. He was so delighted I left. He's always hated me, you know. Do you know what he did to me once? Mother had a youth potion that took off 10 years. When I was 9, he gave it to me to make me minus 1. I kept asking Mother why he destroyed
it. Why have you come here?
A desire of blood, Your Majesty. I have quite a family here, as you know. My dear aunt, Morgan Le Fay, whom I've never seen.
Nor has anyone else. The castle where she lives is quite invisible. It hardly seems reason enough to make such a long journey.
And there's you, Your Majesty. As I was saying, I kept asking Mother why King Lot despised me so. And one day, not long ago, she told me the marvelous news. He's not my father. For once, when she was visiting England, she met an attractive lad named Arthur, invited him into her room, and bewitched him for the night. Is that the way the story goes, Your Majesty?
Yes, Mordred, that is the way the story goes.
You can imagine her surprise when he later became the king of all England.
Very well, Mordred. Now that you are here, what are your plans?
That's for you to decide, Your Majesty.
Very well. I shall tell you what I wish, what I want, what I suggest. That you stay here and become a knight of the Round Table. You have youth, brains, and a proper heritage. Much can be done if you apply yourself.
I shall try, Your Majesty.
Tonight, you have a dinner with the Queen. And you will try to get to know each other better. In the morning, your training will begin. But be warned, no favoritism will be shown. You must prove yourself with virtue and proper deeds.
Oh, I shall, Your Majesty.
The adage, blood is thicker than water, was created by undeserving relatives.
too much time in that precious civil court of yours.
Oh, I can't help it, Jenny. I only mean to stay for a moment, but I've become absolutely transfixed. It's not that I'm proud of it, which I am, but before, when disputes were settled with physical combat, I could always tell who was going to win, because I could tell at a glance who was the better swordsman. But now with a jury and judge, why, you never know who's going to win until you hear the verdict. Why, it's positively riveting.
I know it is, but the jury does worry me, Arthur. They don't know the people involved. They really don't care who wins. Are you sure it's so wise to trust people so impartial?
Point here.
Arthur! Arthur.
Oh, good evening, ma'am. Forgive me, damn it. But damn it, Arthur, yours miserable has got to speak up.
About what?
Oh, not about what. About who?
What?
Mordred, that's what.
Please, Pelly, let's not talk about Mordred. It's the first time in a month he's not coming to dinner, and I feel as if I were going to a party.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I must. Arthur, you have to face it. You've sired a scum. And to tell it all, you've let him loose to smell at your own court. Do you have any idea what foul things he's saying and doing?
Yes, I do. Oh, do you?
Do you know the skunky way he's rallying up the knights?
He's preying on their provincials and making them yearn for their own lives.
You know that. When he leaves every afternoon, do you know where he goes?
He's searching the forest for his aunt, Morgan Le Fay.
You know that too. I'll wager you don't know what he's saying about chivalry.
He's mocking with bold deliverance.
You know all that?
Yes, and I know why. To destroy me and those I love. And to make his inheritance come quicker.
Then why? In the holy name of heaven, don't you do something about it, Arthur?
Because we practice civil law now. We cannot take the law back into our own hands. It is not against the law to speak out, nor is it against the law to walk in the woods. When he breaks the law will punish him.
Oh, are you trying to say a man has to be killed before he can attack?
Oh, I'm afraid I don't have an answer for that, Pelly.
Well, Arthur, I never thought I'd say it, but what you need is a new idea.
And what shall be found, Pelly? You shall see.
I hope so, ma'am. I'm very worried. You know, in many ways, questing after the beast is a lot easier than living with people. The summer scorches, and the winter chills. The wind slaps you about a bit, and the rain drenches, but it's orderly. You can count on it. And they never all get together and do it to you at the same time. But with people. I'm not talking about you, ma'am. Or you, Arthur. You're special people. That's why I stay on, I suppose.
Pelly, I could do with some fresh air. Well, why don't we go pot shooting tomorrow?
That's the best idea you've had yet, Arthur. Fresh air, green fields. Coming, ma'am.
No, Pelly.
Oh, just the boys. Arthur, will you bring the bows and arrows and I'll bring the sandwiches.
I hope you don't know the truth about Mordred. Well, I don't, neither should you. The one thing I can say about him is that he's bound to marry well. But he's a bargain.
And yet, Jenny, there he is. And even if he were banished, he would still remain a constant menace to the throne. And what? Jenny, don't you wish you'd never been born a queen sometimes?
Oh, occasionally I do. Well, it's never being alone that bothers me most. Do you know I have never been without someone with me in my entire life? Neither in Camelot or Camelot. I mean, completely solitary, totally alone. Sometimes the leash of the castle were empty. Everyone gone. No one here but me. Do you know what I would do? I would lock every door. being a queen can be.
Can be what?
A weary load. Oh, that dreadful boy. One more burden we could put right well to it out.
And yet, a burden we cannot escape.
Royalty never can. Why is that, Arthur? Other people do. What do they do? Bombs? Hooks? Blacksmiths? What do the simple folk do to help them escape the famine? The shepherd who is ailing, the milkmaid who is belong, the cobbler who is wailing, for nailing his thumb.
Morgan. Dear sweet Aunt Morgan. Dear sweet Queen Aunt Morgan. Can you not hear me?
Get away, Morgan! Get away! You are a nasty little boy. I told you to become a nasty little man.
I beseech you, Your Majesty. Give me a moment of your time.
Not now, Morgan. I'm eating my dinner. I shan't be finished till tomorrow.
What a pity. And I have chocolates.
Chocolates? You say you have chocolates.
Now look here, whatever your name is, I don't want to smudge it around that swampy little mind of yours. But while the king is away, I am in charge of this palace. I'm not a firm believer in all this civil law nonsense. You make one false move, you'll face the jury in two sections. Carry the head in myself. Gladly. Wouldn't I love that? You medieval delinquent?
Perhaps it would be better if we hadn't said a word to each other at all.
invincible English calm.
I'm just as tortured, just as anguished as you. But what should we do to the man we both love? Run away? Publicly humiliate him? Make him declare war on you, or either one of you, if not both, would be killed, along with thousands of others. Lance, what kind of heartbreaking solution is that?
Thank you.
go to England with you. We want to try to put things right.
This war will do horrible harm to the table, Arthur.
Let us pay for what we've done.
At the stake? No. I won't take you back. I shan't let you return. For what end? Justice? They've forgotten justice. They want revenge. Revenge in the most worthless of causes. Those are old, dreadful days we tried to put to sleep forever. No, the table is dead. It exists no longer.
What?
Over 80 knights were killed in the yard. Mordred has fled with some others to Orkney. I suppose to raise an army against me. The rest are in their tents, itching for dawn, cheerful to be at war again. Those all dreadful days, to sleep forever.
It's your wish, Arthur, this dread battle go on?
No, lads, it's not my wish, but oh, I can think no longer. Oh, what light thinking is. Oh, I wish I'd never tried it at all. All this we've been through, for nothing, but a thought, an idea. Without substance, life, reality, all the charade begins soon. We must return to Joyous Garde.
Jenny is not at Joyous Garde, Arthur. She stays with the Holy Sisters. Is there nothing to be done?
Nothing. But play out the game and leave the decisions to God. Now go. Battle today. Do you understand?
Yes, Lord.
You'll run behind the line. until the battle is over. You'll return to England, alive. Grow up and grow old. Do you understand?
Yes, Lord.
And for as long as you live, you will remember what I, the king, have commanded.
Yes, Lord.
Each evening from December to December, before you lay your head upon your cot, think back upon the tale that you remember of Camelot. As every person, if he's heard the story, and tell it loud, questing once more for
set of destruction.